Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Welcome Back, Kotter, Helene Limbeck, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Johnny Olsen, are they ready? Are you ready on the left? Ready on the right?
Yeah.
Ready on the firing line? Yeah. Fire! You never heard that.
No, yeah, yes, you are.
You're so physical.
You bet. And you love it, don't you?
No.
You.
No.
You.
All right, what do you say we greet the champ, Laurie Smith, over here? Laurie has $8,550. When the time expired last time, she just had won another game, and that means she's going to go for the big money again. You look very calm, Laurie.
Oh, I'm not.
You're not calm? Are you seething inside? So is Betty. She just puts it. Oh, I'm not supposed to touch the contestants. I better not do that. Listen, we'll see how much money she will win in 1 minute and 4 5/10 seconds. Come back. Here we are with Laurie Smith. This is her third time up here. She will try to increase her winnings of $8,550. Let's see how she does. We polled the studio audience in this very building not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank Charlie. Blank Charlie. Remember, if you match the answer those people wrote down most frequently, you get $500. If you match the answer they wrote down second most often, you get $250. And for matching their third most popular answer, you get $100. And three of our six celebrities will kindly consent to assist you.
All right. Richard, please.
Bonnie Prince Charlie.
Bonnie Prince Charlie.
Yes. I just said that.
Yes, he was here recently, wasn't he?
Certainly was. Yes.
And he was a Bonnie fellow.
Brett,
what about... Why are you giggling?
Yeah.
What about Good Time Charlie?
Good Time Charlie. Good Time Charlie.
Betty?
Oh, dear. It's spelled differently. It's spelled differently, but how about where's?
Where's Charlie? That's all right. That's okay. Where apostrophe S?
That would be better.
Where's Charlie?
Better do this one. I know. Don't turn on me.
Where's Charlie? Bonnie Prince Charlie and Good Time Charlie are the three. Now, think it over carefully. Give us a decision here. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
I'll take Good Time Charlie.
Good Time Charlie with Brett's answer. Let's find out. What's that? One at a time, please. I said one at a time. Sorry. Sorry, Charlie. Oh, the tuna thing. Oh, yeah. Well, I may be up there. Let's find out. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Creeping Charlie.
He was here.
I have some of that.
He was here recently.
That's right. That's right. He was here. He's the one who was just shouting at you. May we see the next one, please?
Yeah.
Uncle Charlie, so far they haven't got anything they gave you over there.
Who's Uncle Charlie?
All right, this is the last chance for Good Time Charlie. Slide it. You got it. Very good. That's very good judgment on Laurie Smith's part. She has picked up another $500. Now going to play for 10 times that amount. Another $5,000 shot at it here. And we'll give you the money if you'll match one of them exactly.
Richard, please.
All right. Good luck to you. Here it is, worth $5,000. Richard, it reads as follows. Penalty blank. Penalty blank. Laurie, give us the answer that Richard has written. We give you $5,000. It's a simple, fair exchange.
Penalty flag.
Penalty flag. Where do they do that?
I'm sorry, I didn't.
Penalty flag, she says. What do you say, Richard?
Well, we were in the same thought, because I had sport. Penalty box.
hockey, right. Well, Laurie, you're up to $9,000, so let's welcome a new player now, Maureen Farrell. Hello, Maureen.
Hello. Hi.
We welcome you. Just throw it in here, Jane. Would you tell us the story of your life in 8 or 12 seconds? Thank you.
Well, I'm a new bride of about 7 weeks.
Really?
I married a man that I dated off and on for 17 years. Yes? And I'm in business for myself.
Really? What do you do?
I'm a temporary secretary.
I see. Mm-hmm. 17 years,
yes. Yes.
Who couldn't make up his or her mind?
We couldn't.
17 years, on and off.
Yes.
Well, I'm very happy for you.
Oh, yes, so am I. Finally.
Congratulations to him for getting you.
Oh, thank you.
All right, Maureen, you may have A or B.
I'll have B.
Okay, this is it.
I just have a question from that last board. What is Uncle Charlie? What does that mean?
Uncle Charlie. My three sons.
Oh,
that old series. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Remember?
Obviously more well known than
Fred McMurray's
William
father. Yeah, right.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Ready? The customer at the Playboy Club said, "That." Am I talking too loud for you up there?
But he makes me mad. I said William Frawley played Uncle Charlie, and he said,
no,
Uncle Charlie.
You just said William Demarest.
It's William Demarest.
Oh. Yes. But the thing, the whole idea is, you see,
Vincent Price was not the flan.
Listen.
David Heddison.
No, the whole idea here is, when I am speaking,
yes,
it would help a little if no one else up here is speaking at the same time.
You've been off since the knot didn't come out orange. I was in the dressing room, and your valet, Dayton, said, make sure the knot comes out orange, and it came out 60 blue, 20 there's, yellow, and hardly any orange.
There's quite a bit of orange.
You were saying?
I was saying, at the customer at the Playboy Club said, that bunny is so fat.
How fat is she?
She doesn't look like a bunny. She looks like a blank with a cotton tail. That's how fat
that bunny is so fat.
That bunny is so
she
fat,
looks
she doesn't
like
look like a
blank.
Bunny. She looks like a blank with a cotton tail.
Oh, I got it.
Good.
From the top. Good girl.
Okay.
Ha-ha!
Ha-ha! Here we go. Maureen Farrell. The customer at the Playboy Club said that bunny is so fat, she doesn't look like a bunny. She looks like a blank with a cotton tail.
Elephant.
Yay! Elephant. All right, anything big would be appropriate. Elephant, she said.
Elephant is close, but she's wrong. Unfortunately, the answer is hippo.
Hippo! All right. All right, Brett.
William Demarest replaced William Frawley in My Three Sons.
Is she right?
When she's right, she's right, which is so seldom. Elephant.
Elephant. All right.
How could I know what happens when I'm in kindergarten?
Ha! You wish.
Elephant.
All right. There's another one. That's two for Maureen. That bunny is so fat, she doesn't look like a Playboy bunny. She looks like an elephant with a cotton tail. What do you say to that, Helene?
Well, I was going to say those things, but I went back to my old, good old answer, which is house.
Yes.
Didn't work last time either, but I thought I'd try again. Don't get violent.
No, I will.
No more house.
All right.
More house.
Didn't work once, twice, maybe the third time will be a charm.
Richard, elephant is what
we
want.
This might be a match. Uncle Hippo.
Hippo. No, not quite fat enough. Yes. And not a long enough nose there.
I'm sorry, animal lover that I am. I was thinking hippopotamus, and I didn't think about it.
Hippopotamus, sir. Well, you got two. That's quite unusual for first round. You ready for yours?
Yes.
Well, we're not. First, we got this for you. Hurry back. Now, we're ready to carry on here. The other half of round one. Laurie, this is your question. Everyone plays. Charles Nelson Reilly said...
Oh. It stinks.
Last week was really terrible. It was so bad. It was bad enough I had to go to the hospital, but I had to share a room with blank.
Oh,
Give us the reading.
Got it.
Don't want to give us a reading. Okay. All right. Laurie, Charles Nelson Reilly said last week was really terrible. It was bad enough I had to go to the hospital, but I had to share a room with blank.
Brett.
I think she'd be a very interesting roommate, don't you?
I would think so. They'd make a very interesting couple. They'd need a third party, but...
There's Brett. One for her. Jake, get the fly swatter. That fly swatter is... Go backstage and get the fly swatter.
No.
Somebody. No. Bring fly. That fly swatter out here.
No fly will be killed on this show.
You do what you want on your show. If I want to kill a fly on my show...
Ever since that's not...
I'm taking this for fly... I'm sorry. Do that again.
Yes.
Well, actually...
Actually...
Go to the hospital. Share a room with Brett. Brett. And it was hell for her, too.
So neither one of them liked it.
I love to be with you. You know that. We've been at each other's homes. We go out. But don't ever take a six-hour flight at night to Boston sitting next to her. She gets louder and louder.
I was on that flight. Don't tell me. All three of us took the red eye one night to Boston.
Did we have a good time?
George C. Scott was on that flight. Right. Oh, we had a gay time.
Well, some of you did.
Elaine.
Well, I know that I'm the new kid in town, but I can just tell the short time that I've been here that they are the best of friends, so I can't imagine sharing a room with anybody else but Brett. Good
Oh, boy. That's very, very cool. And you have seen the show.
Oh, why do you say that?
Richard, what do you say?
Brett and Charles are good friends of mine, although, of course, they've never been to my home. Brett.
And that's what it's going to be. Yes, I have. Thank you very much. Now, you are a good friend of both Brett and Charles, aren't you?
But the thing is, he had his heart set on Burt Reynolds, and he got Brett instead. Oh, yeah.
Well, you know what that means, Maureen.
Yes.
You've got a choice of A or B, and you've got to match all four remaining celebrities you have not matched in order to stay in the game and achieve a tie. So there you go.
I'll have B.
B. All right. Let's see how it goes.
Somebody's clicking.
Bottom row.
What is that? Wait a minute. What's that noise?
Something.
Oh, they're stapling something? What are you doing? Jack, are you back here? No, he's not. I thought I heard a noise back there. All right.
Get the mouse swatter.
Bert said, I've got the world's biggest dog.
Hush.
I didn't ask you to correspond with me on this.
They're trained.
I've got the world's biggest dog. When I take him for a walk, instead of a fire plug, he uses a fire blank. World's biggest dog. Instead of a fire plug, let's see. Two people do not play. You don't play, you don't play. He does. All right. World's biggest dog.
Shh. He's talking again.
It's all right. Here we go. Maureen,
yes.
Bert said I've got the world's biggest dog. When I take him for a walk, instead of a fire plug, he uses a fire blank.
Truck.
Truck. Seems like a good answer to me, doesn't it, to you? Dick, what'd you say? Have all four fire trucks here.
I was hoping that I would match with Helene because she said house so often. I said firehouse.
That means Laurie Smith wins the game. She had house, station, and there it is. Maureen, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. Thank you. It was fun.
Best wishes to you in your new marriage.
Thank you. Thank you.
Goodbye, Maureen Farrell. We'll send you some gifts, and now we got a message or two just for you. Here we are with Laurie Smith for the fourth time. She has $9,150, and she's going to try again for the big one. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Not too long ago, we polled a bunch of people in this room. We said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank wreck, W-R-E-C-K. If you match the answer they gave us most often, you get $500. If you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. For matching the third most popular answer, you get a total of $100. Now.
Richard?
Ship. Wreck.
Brett? I have one I want to use so bad. What Charles is, an old wreck.
An old wreck.
Betty?
Younger than you.
That's the problem, that they act like that because they were never trained. Train wreck.
Train wreck. So we have a train wreck, shipwreck, and an old wreck. Now you have an option here of choosing one of those, remember, Laurie, or giving us one of your own.
I'll go a ship.
You want a shipwreck? All right. Let's see if we have a shipwreck up there anywhere. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Nervous wreck.
That's also what Charles is.
And Charles is that too, yes. May we see the $250 number? Car wreck. All right, last chance for shipwreck. Slide it, please.
Uncle Charles.
You got it. Congratulations, there's another $500 for you. And remember, you're going to play for the $5,000 one more time now. And we want to give you that money. We're dying to give you the money, but you got to match one celebrity exactly.
Richard, please.
All right, here we go again, Laurie. Good luck to you. Worth $5,000, and it reads as follows. Blank Jazz. J-A-Z-Z. Blank Jazz. Blank Jazz. Now he's finished. You give us an answer that matches his, Laurie, and we give you $5,000. Good luck.
The only thing I can think of is New Orleans Jazz.
New Orleans Jazz. Right. She says New Orleans Jazz will match you for the $5,000, Richard.
You never know how close we are. Dixieland.
Dixieland. Yeah. Yeah, you're in the same
idea. That's
exactly
what it is.
Yeah. All that jazz and other
modern jazz. There's so many. But the object is we both get the same.
Laurie now has $9,650, and she's going to meet a new player now. Who is this? Barry Alshouse. Alshouse.
That's pretty close.
You know Laurie Smith, Barry. Did I say your name correctly?
Alshouse. It's pretty cool.
Alshouse.
Yes.
A-L-S-H-O-U-S-E.
That's right.
Alshouse.
There's your house
right.
Again.
Where are you from? Florida. Originally from Florida. I've moved to Los Angeles about 2 years ago. And I'm working since June. I wasn't working for a while. It's not too cool here. I'm going to school, one of the city colleges here in Los Angeles. I'm working in the theater department there, building sets. And I'm very happy to be here and ready to play.
Well, all right, we're happy to have you, Barry, and we're ready to play, too. You may have A or B.
B for Barry.
B for Barry. Felix said, let me tell you how much my wife loves deep-sea diving. On our wedding night, she hopped into our waterbed wearing blank. That's how much she loves deep-sea diving. Let me tell you how much my wife loves deep-sea diving. On our wedding night, she jumped into our waterbed wearing blank. Okay, bing, 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 finish, 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 and here we go. Barry, Felix said, let me tell you how much my wife loves deep-sea diving. On our wedding night, she hopped into our waterbed wearing blank.
A wetsuit.
A wetsuit. Well, that would have made their first night very difficult, wouldn't
it? Very interesting, anyway. Fins.
Fins is a good response. What do you say?
What's another word for a wetsuit?
I don't know.
It's a rubber suit.
Oh, a rubber suit, that's right. So there's one for Barry. What do you say?
Being associated with the sea, I said wetsuit.
Oh! I thought everybody's going to say all kinds of different things, but then not that. What do you say?
Well, always having to want to go deep sea diving, I said wetsuit.
A wetsuit. Surprised the heck out of me.
Never wanted to go, I said a snorkel.
I would have thought everybody'd say snorkel.
Thought so too.
Snorkel. Two snorkels and three wetsuits and all that. Well, very well done. Don't go away now. Hang around here. We got a little business with America. Join us next time for Match Game 78. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.